Well, that was a fascinating discussion with Mitch Wagner of Information Week and Steve Prentice of Gartner Incorporated. And one of the central parts of the discussion was about the future of Linden Lab. And Mitch actually used the word dire to describe Linden Lab's current situation. We are delighted to have with us John Zdanowski, Z. Linden, CFO of Linden Lab, to give his quick response to what he heard today. Z, thanks so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me. I always appreciate your variety of guests you're able to get into Second Life.
Yeah, well, it's a labor of love. I've really been enjoying this. What do you have to say to Mitch?
Well, I think Mitch is probably commenting about a couple of the active user stats and the unique user stats that we publish. So active users have been relatively steady at about 500,000 users logging in for more than an hour per month over the last year. And our, just people logging in has been in the 800,000 to a million unique users per month. The number that I think we look at that ends up having much more sort of financial relevance to us and to the residents of Second Life is total user hours and then total concurrency. And both of those have shown linear growth since about a year ago. For the six-month period between sort of Q4 of 2006 and Q1 of 2007, it was faster than linear growth, but I think there were some unsustainable components of our growth there that, relative to sort of the blog post that I recently made about our 15% growth from Q4 to Q1 of this year, I think this is at a much more sustainable level of growth. The other number that I think people get confused about at times is premium subscriptions. Originally, premium subscriptions were a great way for us to basically stimulate the economy by giving people Linden dollars long before there was a Lindex. Over last year and the year before, we significantly reduced the stipend, which had the intended effect of slowing down the growth of premiums, and those have been flat at around 90,000. At this point, a premium subscription, as currently configured, is really just the right to own mainland and then a small Linden dollar stipend. But I think we've seen more of the growth in island users and kind of much more diversity of usage on private islands themselves. The mainland, though, has also continued to grow with the average parcel size that each premium user owns continuing to increase. I think the key point here for Mitch is that when your revenue grows from 4 to 10 to 40 to, in the first quarter, about 70 million on a run rate basis, I'm not sure that there are a lot of private companies that that achieve that level of growth at the same time as achieving profitability. And so if our situation is dire, then I just wonder about a lot of other companies that don't really have that kind of financial performance. And it really is kind of surprising to hear that, being the CFO here and looking at our numbers and also being quite transparent about those numbers, probably more transparent than any other private company on the planet.
Well, and we appreciate. And actually, one question I had, when you were in the Metanomics group chat channel last week, you talked a bit about the money that residents are taking out of Second Life. And I'm wondering, how important is that to you as something to be tracking and keeping a finger on?
It's very important. It indicates...
strategy.
It's very important. Can you still hear me?
Yes, I can.
It indicates the overall health of the economy, and that was really the focus of my most recent blog post, was the 15% growth in the user-to-user economy from Q4 to Q1, and then the 17% growth in the Lindex volume from Q4 to Q1. I mentioned in the chat while you were talking that since inception the users have traded over $600 million worth of virtual goods inside Second Life. I'm not sure there's anybody with a tenth of that in an open way like Linden Lab and Second Life have, or maybe even a hundredth of that. And I think that's sort of the most important thing about Second Life is that in-world economy, because that's what attracts a lot of creativity and a lot of really great builders and people providing great experiences. In terms of people cashing out, it's pretty consistent that the Lindex volume represents the sellers on the Lindex primarily represent successful in-world businesses. And so you can look at the 9.2 million I think that we traded that were traded on the Lindex last month, and then roughly about 45% of that in any given month is cashed out by residents. Another 45% of that is paid back to us in fees. And there's a little echo there in fees for land and other things, and that. The fees that come back to us from basically sellers on the Lindex also translate into more than half of our overall revenue billings. And so the success of the in-world economy is tied intimately to our own success. And I think some of these numbers also get confused when compared to last year, and some of the three main problems of last year were sort of hypergrowth and then fraud, and then shutting down gambling and then implementing the VAT. And clearly shutting down gambling significantly reduced user-to-user transactions, but as you can see on the charts on the Lindex, it had absolutely no impact on the value of the Linden dollar relative to the US dollar. And that to me meant, while it was about 40% of the user-to-user transactions, because often gambling transactions are quite circular in nature and the net is quite small, the overall impact of gambling on the money supply was only about 3%. And the money supply growth slowed about 3% for 1 month and then returned to its normal growing pattern. So, all the indications that I see, and I'd be happy to sit down with Mitch. Personally, I think he's here in the Bay Area, and walk him through some of these numbers and say, it's hard to imagine. Certainly, we've got lots of problems of stability and some growing pains. But I think our focus is in the right area. The IBM announcement indicates that we're looking for an enterprise solutions provider like IBM to really help us make Second Life and the technology enterprise ready. We're working with the architecture working group to establish standards in the space. And all the while, we're continuing to support and maintain, a rapidly growing in-world economy, and continue to add in, great features like the upgrade of Havoc, and the implementation of Windlight, and there's definitely a lot going on, and certainly no one would like our stability to be, much greater than it is than me. I think in comparison to the size of other worlds and the size of things like that, I think the situation is far from dire from that perspective.